Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about monitor calibration, what it is, why you should do it, and how you can do it, all within the time it takes you to drink a cup of coffee. Now, I've been calibrating my monitor for a few years now, but I've just recently changed my calibration device, so I thought it's a good time to revisit the topic and talk to you about why I think it's really important for photographers to use a calibrated display. So why do we calibrate our monitors? Well, every monitor displays colors slightly differently, and the out-of-the-box brightness settings can vary significantly. So calibration is a process of measuring that color, contrast, and brightness output and matching it to international standards. For example, your computer may ask your monitor to display the color blue 66, but the actual color that the monitor displays might be something like blue 68 or even blue 64. So what calibration will do is it will measure the difference between the expected output and the actual output of your monitor, and it will create a profile from all that information so your computer can adjust its display accordingly. So why should I even bother? I hear you cry. After all, you've probably been using an uncalibrated display for many years and you've never had any problems with your images. Yes, it is true that most people will view your images on an uncalibrated display, but there are still some good reasons why you would want to use a calibrated display. Perhaps one of the biggest reasons to run a calibrated display is if you print your images. So whether you send them to a lab or you print at home, you will want to ensure that the colours you see on the screen are going to match the colours of the printed output. There seems little point in spending all that time and money to make a print only for the two outputs to differ. It's not just colours though. The internet is awash with stories of people who have printed out images either at home or through a lab and they've come out really dark. This is because the monitor that you get, when it comes out of the box, typically the brightness levels are set to really high. Calibration will help you set that monitor brightness to a more appropriate level for creating prints. But even if you don't print your images, you might well want to submit them to magazines or even photographic competitions. So you will want to make sure that the brightness levels, contrast, and colors are as accurate as possible. So if you want people to view your images in the way that you intended them to, then monitor calibration really is essential. Well, that's all very well, isn't it? But isn't monitor calibration complicated, time-consuming, and expensive? Well, no, it doesn't have to be that way. Like I said at the top of the video, I've just picked up one of these. It's a SpyderX device. Now, I've recently changed, as I said. Now, the reason I changed monitor calibration devices is I want something that worked directly with the calibration routines within my ISO monitor. Now, I appreciate not everyone has an ISO monitor, and besides, you know, the colors are pretty accurate out the box with that monitor. So what I've decided to do for this video is calibrate my secondary display instead. So I've got the software all installed, so why don't we make a start? Okay, let's get on with our calibration. So you can see I've already got the software loaded here. I've already told the software a little bit about the type of monitor that I have. So it's asking me to put the calibration device on the screen. So I just pull this apart. The calibration device is now placed against the monitor. It's at a slight angle, and this ensures that the calibration device lies flat against the screen. So I'll click on next. Now, what's happening now is the software is cycling through a number of different colors, and the calibration device is measuring that output. Now, the calibration software is asking me to set my monitor brightness. I've got it set, well, the target is set for 99. I've got it set at 96, which is actually already within the level or the tolerance that it's looking for. So I'm quite happy that that's set correctly. And I'm just gonna click an update so it just does a quick measurement. Measurement's complete, it's within tolerance. I'm just gonna click and continue. And it will carry on cycling through the relevant colors. Now that the calibration is done and the profile is saved, I can check to see what the difference between an uncalibrated view was and now what it looks like with a calibrated profile. I can click on the switch button here within the Spider software, and I can switch between calibrated and uncalibrated. Now, I'm not sure how clearly you can see this on a video recording, but for me, the difference is actually quite significant. Also, if I wanted to check on one of my own pictures, it allows me to open up one of my own photographs. And with my own photograph loaded, I can switch between calibrated and uncalibrated. That's it. I now have a calibrated display with accurate colors. Well, hopefully this video has given you a slightly better understanding of what monitor calibration is and how, with a small investment in time and money, you too can have a calibrated workflow. So you can be confident that the image that you edit on your computer will match the chosen output. So whether that's a print at home, a lab print, a competition entry, or even a magazine feature. If you want to pick up one of the SpyderX devices, I'll include a link for that in the bottom in the video description. Well, I do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please do consider leaving me a comment. I do try and read and reply to everyone's comments. And if you did like this video, please also consider subscribing. Also, check out my blog. I do make a new post there every single week. And perhaps maybe check out some of my other videos, perhaps one of my 5-minute photo adventure videos, or if you're interested in photography books, the On My Bookshelf series as well. I'll see you in the next video.